In literally less than 5 minutes, I was able to generate over 100 different modular features in Inkscape, including eyes, noses, ears, hair, and even hands and feet. These features are generic and reusable, and they make prototyping hands in particular incredibly fast. Today I'll show you how I built this library, how you can use it in your own workflow, and why it can completely change the way you approach character design in Inkscape. I recently released a beginner-friendly character design course in Inkscape that's all about creating variations, experimenting with shapes and using the power of vector illustration to quickly try dozens of ideas. Link in the description, by the way. This video is a perfect companion to that theme. Vector art has its weaknesses compared to traditional drawing, but if you lean into what vectors do best, reusability, variation, and speed, you can actually turn those weaknesses into strengths. I've always said that the real power of vector illustration is in reusing and recombining assets. Instead of drawing everything from scratch, you can treat your character, or heads in this case, like building blocks, almost like assembling a Lego. The beauty of this approach is that once you have a library of assets, like this one, you can explore countless possibilities without even having to draw. So, how did I make over 100 features in literally 5 minutes? The truth is, I didn't draw them. I went on Pinterest, searched for cartoon features and cartoon tutorials, and found these images with collections of noses, eyes, ears, and hair shapes that are clearly made to be studied. From there, I imported them into Inkscape and used the Trace Bitmap tool that I've talked about multiple times already in more than one tutorial of mine. After a quick cleanup, separating them into logical steps and adding white fields so they could be overlapped, I immediately had a huge variety of modular assets ready to be tested on new characters. Of course, there are some limitations you should keep in mind. First, this technique works best for faces. Faces in cartoons are naturally modular. Eyes, noses, mouths, and ears tend to follow clear, reusable shapes in cartoons. You can sometimes get decent hands, feet, or even bits of hair this way, but because those parts can appear in infinite poses and perspectives, they often end up more limiting than useful. Second, there is the issue of line quality. The Trace Bitmap tool isn't perfect. The lines it produces can look rough or uneven, especially if you stretch or scale them to fit a face. That's why these features work best as a starting point. You'll usually want to redraw and clean them up later. And finally, there is the question of legality and ethics. The reality is that no one will notice if you use a generic eye shape that appears in 100 different cartoons. But since we are dealing with tracing artwork, it's best to stick to assets that are clearly generic and widely used, things you see in tutorials, or as common building blocks across many styles. Avoid tracing unique designs or directly copying features from recognizable characters. Think of this technique as a prototyping tool to spark ideas, not as a way to borrow in someone else's artwork. So let me show you how I actually use this technique to generate a few characters' heads. A while back I made a video about designing heads in 3 simple steps, and I think those steps still apply here. They are: quickly throw elements together to come up with a concept, create variations to refine that concept, and redraw your favorite design into a polished final character. So let's go back to this example. Step 1 is all about exploration. I'll start combining random features, mouths, eyes, noses, hair, just to see what kind of concept emerges. You could also take inspiration from existing characters, or even people you know. The goal here isn't perfection, it's simply to discover an idea that's worth developing. And this is where having a library of hundreds of assets really makes a difference. You have so much freedom to explore compared to being limited to just a handful of options. Once you have a promising concept, step 2 is to create variations. This is where I like to play with proportions, scaling features up and down, swapping parts, and making subtle changes to see how the design evolves. In Inkscape, I like to use this really helpful workflow, where I duplicate the design before making changes. If I like the new version, I keep it, and duplicate it again for the next round. If I don't, I just delete it. The result is this evolutionary process, where each iteration gets closer to a design I really like. Finally, step 3 is to redraw the design from the ground up. At this stage, I'm not relying on the rough stock assets anymore. I'm using the chosen variation as a guide and refining everything into clean, consistent lines. This is also where I customize the design, making small adjustments so the character feels unique and personal, rather than assembled from pre-made parts. And that's the process, from a rough prototype made of modular features to a finished, original character. And that's the technique, a super fast way to generate characters in Inkscape using modular features. It's not about copying, it's about prototyping, experimenting and finding new directions quickly. If you enjoy this, you'll probably love my new beginner course on character design in Inkscape. It dives deeper into these ideas of variation and experimentation, and shows you how to create dozens of characters with simple vector techniques. You'll find the link in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!